Some people will believe anything if you whisper it to them. Louis B. Neiser, Thinking on Your Feet. TV just feeds you. Radio involves you. Hyman Brown. Radio is a creative theater of the mind. Wolfman Jack Smith. Chapter 3. How to Buy Effective Radio. Advertising on radio and other types of broadcasting media is different than print because your commercial disappears after it's played. While print advertising can be savored, radio advertising is consumed. If a commercial plays at 7:20 in the morning, you just can't listen to it again if you missed the address or phone number. You have to wait until the commercial plays again. That's the nature of broadcast advertising. Now, while all this may seem rather obvious, understanding this difference plays an important role in how you buy radio time. Frequency is a vital element in radio's effectiveness. Since you can't automatically recall the radio commercial and hear it again, you've got to hear the same commercial 2, 4, or 6 times before the message sinks in. If you miss the address the first time, you consciously or subconsciously are hoping the commercial will return soon so you can get the information you need. That's the way radio advertising works, and that's also the way you should buy it. Most of the time, radio should be bought in chunks. High frequency over a short period of time is much more effective than low frequency over a longer period of time. Why? So your audience can hear your spot again and get more information out of it. For example, if you wanted to advertise a 2-week campaign and you could afford 42 radio commercials, I'd recommend the following buy. Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays, 3 spots between 7 and 9 a.m., and 4 spots between 3 and 6 p.m. for 2 weeks. Notice that I concentrated both my day periods and my hour periods. This utilizes something I call the radio splash theory. By advertising in concentrated areas in tight day groups, you seem larger than you really are, and believe it or not, people hear your concentrated campaign for 2 or 3 days and think you're on all the time. Now, the amateur might buy 3 spots every day on the station for 14 days. That's 42 spots as well. But the campaign would not be nearly as effective. Think of the radio splash theory like throwing rocks in a pond. A handful of large rocks makes a bigger splash than throwing a tiny pebble a bunch of times, and it attracts more attention. Buying radio time poorly was probably not the poor amateur's fault. He was probably sold the time by an overzealous radio salesperson. You see, radio time is priced differently at different times of the day. The most expensive time is called drive time, which is normally 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. And it's called drive time for a simple reason. It's when people are driving to and from work. And it's also the time when people listen to their radios. So, listenership is usually higher during those periods than any other time. Late morning, early afternoon, evening, and late evening rates are lower because fewer people listen. But it leaves the radio station with a problem. How can they sell all that time that isn't prime? Well, the good old boys in radio came up with something called TAP, which stands for Total Audience Plan. TAP normally splits your buy into thirds, giving you one-third drive time, one-third late morning, early afternoon, and one-third evening. Total audience is a bit of a misnomer because you're attempting to hit the station's entire audience even when there are just a few listeners. Who really cares if you buy 100% of the station's audience? What's really important is buying time when people are listening, not when they're not. And TAP buys you only one-third of the most desirable time. But TAP costs less, and it's attractive to a lot of shoppers, like the radio buying amateur I mentioned earlier. Unless there's a darn good reason, and there are a few, you should only advertise when people are listening. And that means buying drive time, even if it costs a bit more. Think about this for a second. The people who understand how to buy radio, usually advertising agencies, buy up the most effective times. That leaves a lot of time the station wants to sell. So, by selling TAPs and other promotions, they effectively sell their station's available airtime, and it's usually sold direct to businesses that don't know much about the nature of radio. When you talk directly to a radio representative, you take the chance of being talked into some special deal that includes the airtimes the professionals don't want. But if they don't want those times, you shouldn't either. I'd break the radio splash theory under a couple of conditions. For instance, if I signed up sponsoring a popular show on a daily basis, say something like The Paul Harvey Show, I'd be only advertising once a day. But the audience is much more regular. Within a week, there's a good chance they'd hear my spot at least 3 to 4 times. Also, I have bought commercials in late morning, early afternoon, evening, and TAP, but only for specific audience or timing reasons. If your audience is housewives, you might be better off advertising in late morning or early afternoon. Or if you have a 24-hour restaurant, evening or late evening commercial time could remind the people to come in during those late hours. Personally, I found TAP to be most effective in the summer, when people are listening to the radio more hours in the day. Events that appeal to mass popularity, like concerts, circuses, fairs, sports, etc., seem to be the best suited for the nature of the TAP. That brings up an interesting medium phenomenon. Radio listenership increases in the spring and summer, while the audience for television increases in the fall and winter and decreases in the summer. This is an important consideration when you are picking advertising media to use. Of course, it would be ideal to advertise on the station you listen to and that's all, but it might not be good advertising. A good radio campaign should use, if possible, 3 or more stations with spots scheduled at the same time. That's because it often takes at least several stations to get a demographic reach similar to other media like television or newspapers. You may have 20 or 30 radio stations that share your market, but most cities have 1 or 2 newspapers and 4 or 5 television stations, not including cable. Using several stations to achieve the same demographic share is simply common sense. To find the most popular stations in the demographics you want to reach, it's important to look at the most recent surveys. Your advertising agency can supply them, or you can usually ask any radio salesperson for a copy. Arbitron, often referred to as the ARB or ARB, is one of the main publishers of radio surveys. These surveys tell, 1, how many people are listening during certain times of day on each station in your market, and 2, a demographic breakdown of those listeners. If you want to advertise to teenage women, just see what stations are most popular in the corresponding demographic segment. The surveys usually tell you the best time to reach those teenage women as well. The world revolves around supply and demand, so expect to pay top dollar for the most popular station in the market. When a survey comes out, radio stations revise their rates accordingly. In fact, most stations have price levels in their rate cards, so they don't have to go to the print shop every time they change rates. They just change levels instead. But since we're talking about costs, also remember this. Radio may be the most negotiable advertising medium in the world. One of the reasons is that there are a lot of stations in every market, and competition for your advertising is keen. It doesn't matter if you or your advertising agency does the negotiating either. You'll get the best results when you plan your advertising purchases ahead. If you're planning to advertise a week, a month, or 3 months, ask the radio station for a package deal. Get comparisons from similarly rated stations. You should be able to get price reductions, free commercial times, and free participation in special promotions by committing your dollars in a schedule you probably were going to buy anyway. If you make a major radio buy, you should never have to pay a standard rate card price. I like radio because you can buy both demographics and audience. You can reach a certain number of people and a certain type of people. If you're selling a rural product like Western bootwear, it's not hard to pick the music format of the station you'll advertise on. Business products work well on all news stations, and the beat goes on. Radio delivers exclusive types of audiences. In some cases, you don't get nearly the number of people, but you get a highly targeted group of people. And the more precisely you can hit the audience you're trying to reach, the less you pay for reaching waste demographics, or in other words, people who are not in the market for your product or service. But buying efficient airtime should not be your final goal. Getting the audience to listen to your commercial is the only way you're going to influence their behavior and sell them. Ever notice how a lot of the commercials on radio sound the same? Guess what? They were probably produced by the radio station using the same announcers and the same old tired assembly line techniques. My advice is just the same as it is for print advertising. Be different. Be bold. Stand out from the crowd. And don't let the radio station write and produce your spot. 9 times out of 10, you'll get the kind of commercial that people ignore or turn down instead of up. And all the trouble you went to get the right audience and the right stations at the right price will simply be wasted. I suggest using your advertising agency or a good audio commercial production house. If you use these services, make sure they don't pass off an ordinary spot on you and let the station produce it anyway. Make sure there's a spark that could ignite your audience's attention. And make sure you don't use the same announcer who works on the station that you're buying time on. Again, don't forget to sell. A few tips. 1. If you're including your address in the commercial, simplify it. Instead of 134525 East Pines, say, at the corner of First and Pines, next to Gumby's. It's easier to remember. 2. I hate phone numbers in radio because I just can't imagine people remembering them or writing them down. If you have to mention your phone, refer to the yellow pages in the phone book. If you aren't in the phone book, put an ad in the newspaper and mention that instead. 3. Radio does work better when you combine it with other advertising media. Remember the synergistic approach? You can even cheat a little by mentioning your newspaper ad, TV commercial, or billboard inside your radio commercial. 4. Check out the price differences between 60-second commercials and 30-second commercials. Normally, 30-second commercials are only one-third less than 60s, and that makes 60-second commercials a lot better value. Remember, radio means repetition. Use the radio splash theory and make your advertising seem more extensive than it really is. Radio is a versatile and quickly changeable advertising medium that can work very well for the common business, as long as you use common sense, that is.